Today, I'll be explaining how to add and customize teams, spawn points, and be able to spawn with tools in your Roblox games. First, make sure you have Roblox Studio installed so you can edit your games. Currently, you can download Roblox Studio from roblox.com/create, in addition to the new creator dashboard at create.roblox.com. Both of these links will be in the description of the video. When you open up Roblox Studio, you can create a new game through the New tab. I recommend using either the Base Plate or Classic Base Plate preset if you want to start from scratch with an empty environment. Any game that you create can be found through the My Games tab. Clicking on the image of a game in this section will allow you to start editing it. From here, make sure you have the Explorer and Properties windows enabled. You can enable these through the View tab at the top left of the screen. These windows are important because the Explorer contains everything in your game, and the Properties allows you to edit the characteristics of objects to change how the game looks. After that, make sure the Team service is visible in the Explorer. If it isn't there, here are two ways you can add it into your game. The first way involves going to the Model tab at the top left of the screen, then selecting the Service button. This opens a new window that contains services you can add to the Explorer. After you click on Teams, select the Insert button, and the Team service should appear in the Explorer. If that didn't work, click on the Insert Object button that is next to the Service button. This opens up the Insert Object window. From here, type in Team in the search bar, then select and drag the Team object into the game at the center of your screen, or the Explorer. Now we can start to add, then customize the teams and spawn points. To begin, select the plus button next to the Team service. This is another window that allows you to add objects into your game. After adding a new team, you can rename it by right-clicking on it, then selecting Rename. I'm going to name this team Teachers, and then I'll create another team that is called Roblox Scripting Students. Team names can include multiple words, numbers, and special characters such as underscores and question marks. Next, we need to understand how to customize our teams. After selecting a team in the Explorer, look at the Properties window. If the auto-assignable property has a checkmark, players can be automatically placed onto this team when they join the game. If multiple teams have this property enabled, any players that join will be placed onto the auto-assignable team with the least amount of players. If you turn off this property, players will only be able to join that team from spawn points and scripts with code that updates a player's team. Team color is the most important property of a team. This is what allows you to create team-only spawn points that players' characters will be able to respawn on. Make sure that each team has a different team color. If multiple teams have the same team color, only one of those teams will appear on the in-game player list, and this usually prevents players from being able to join other teams that have the same team color. From here, we can start to add and customize spawn points. You can add a spawn point, which is officially called a spawn location, from the Model tab, the Insert Object window, in addition to the plus button when hovering over objects in the Explorer. To start, we will customize two spawn points so that our two teams in the game have one spawn point each. After selecting a spawn point, scroll down in the Properties window until you reach the Team category. This is where all of its team-related properties will be. In order to link a spawn point with a team, the team color property of the spawn point and the team must be exactly the same. For example, because the Roblox Scripting Students team has a team color value of New Yeller, the spawn point also needs to have New Yeller for its team color property. This means that the brick color of the spawn point that you visually see when looking at it in the workspace does not need to be the same. However, it's usually recommended to make the brick color property the exact same as the team color so that it's easier for the players to know which spawn point is linked with a team. Additionally, you can have multiple spawn points linked with a single team. Players will respawn at a random available spawn point. Now, I will explain some other important properties of a spawn point. First, the Allow Team Change on Touch property allows players to step on the spawn point to join the team that the spawn point is linked with. Next, the neutral property allows any player to respawn there, even if the spawn point is linked with a team. If both of these properties are enabled at the same time, any player that steps on the spawn point will be removed from their current team and become neutral. Even though it looks like they were placed onto a team called neutral, this just means that the player is no longer on any team. If none of the players are neutral, this will disappear from the player list. Other properties that you should be aware of include duration, which lets you choose how long a player will be invincible for after respawning at a spawn point. If the duration is set to 0 seconds, the player will not spawn with a force field, and they will be able to take damage. After this, the enabled property allows you to decide if players will be able to respawn at this spawn point. If this property is turned off, players will not respawn there or be able to step on it to join the team that the spawn point is linked to, even if the allow team change on touch property has been enabled. Finally, if you want to change the amount of time it takes to respawn, select the player's service in the Explorer, then update the respawn time property. This shows how many seconds it will take for a player's character to respawn when the character autoloads property is enabled. If the respawn time is set to 0 seconds, players' characters will respawn instantly. On a side note, if you want to change the order of the teams in the player list, it goes in the order of the team that was created first to the one that was created last. You can either rename and update the properties of existing teams to be in the intended order, or you can add new teams and set it up that way instead. Now we can start to add tools into our game for every player to use. If you want to have team-only items, please refer to the tutorial at the top right of the screen instead. Here, I'll be walking you through two ways you can add existing tools into your game. The first way is through the Creator Marketplace. In Roblox Studio, this can be accessed through the Toolbox, which you can enable from the View tab. After that, select the Marketplace button. Then make sure you've selected the Models category from the drop-down menu. You can search for the names of items you want to add to your game, but you need to be careful with what you use because some models might include scripts with malicious code that could reduce the quality and performance of your game if it's not removed. Because of this, I recommend starting out by using models from trustworthy developers, such as the official Roblox account. To find available items that have been published by specific developers, select the Filter button next to the search bar. A new window should appear where you can type in the username of another player on the platform. You can then select one of the options, then click on Apply to be presented with items that have been published and made available to use by that player. After clicking on one of the items, it will be added to the workspace of your game. If it was just a tool on its own, you'll be prompted to add the item to the starter pack, which is where you can add tools that every player should receive when their character respawns. If this wasn't prompted, you can always manually move the tool directly into the starter pack. However, if you don't find what you need from the toolbox, you can also add tools into your game that have been created and published to the catalog or avatar shop by Roblox. This can be achieved through using code in Roblox Studio's command bar that can be enabled from the View tab. Before I explain the rest of this process, here is the code that we will be modifying and using in the command bar, which will also be included in the resources section of this video's description. This code accesses the insert service, which allows us to add an item from the Roblox website that has an ID of this number. We will be replacing the number 1 with the ID of an item on the Roblox website. First, you can paste this code into the command bar, so it'll be ready to modify once we find what we need from the avatar shop. After that, open the avatar shop on Roblox, then select either the featured gear section in the featured category or the gear section that is currently in the accessories category. This will make sure that we only view items that are tools that can be added to our game. After finding an item you want to add, copy the number in the web address bar, then go back into Roblox Studio and replace the number 1 in the command bar with the number you got from the Roblox website. After clicking Enter on your keyboard, this will add the tool into the workspace inside of a model. You can then place the tool directly into the starter pack, and players will be able to equip it upon spawning into the workspace. If the tool isn't appearing when the player tries to equip it, make sure that there's a part directly inside of the tool that is named Handle with a capital H. This is necessary for tools that have the Requires Handle property enabled, which includes the majority of tools because the property is enabled by default. If the player's character is being teleported somewhere else in the game, or is unable to move upon equipping the tool, make sure that none of the parts inside the tool have the Anchored property enabled. When the Anchored property is enabled for a part, the part is no longer affected by physics, and therefore cannot be moved by the player's character manually. If you want or don't want players to be able to drop a tool onto the ground, select the tool in the Explorer, look at the Properties window, then turn on or off the Can Be Dropped property. Leave a like on the video if this was helpful, consider watching the videos on screen for more, and if you have any questions, concerns, or suggestions, post a comment down below. Have a wonderful day.